Good morning, students. Today we'll be learning about approximation, an international system of writing numbers in a number system. Now the question arises, what is approximation? Approximation can be defined as a process of finding a number acceptably close to an exact value. Now, what does it mean? We'll understand it with the help of one example. Like, you all must have heard about the term pi, right? Not choco pi, but pi in maths, right? Pi, the value of pi is derived by dividing 22 by 7. And when we divide 22 by 7, we get 3.14159 and so on. But we approximate this value and we take the value of pi as 3.14. So the number that is obtained is termed as approximation or approximate number. Right? In our course, we have to deal with rounding off. What is rounding off? Rounding off is one of the forms of approximation. That means all rounding offs are approximations, but all approximations are not rounding off. In our book, rounding off of nearest 10, nearest 1000, nearest 100 is given, and three different methods are given. So I have clubbed all the three methods into one so that we can do rounding off in a much easier way. To round off a number to any given place, we need to follow these three steps. Step number one says, select the immediate place on the right side of the given place. Given place is the place that is mentioned in the question. And just on the right side, whichever place is given, that will be our selected place. Step two, if the digit on the place selected, the place that we are selecting, the digit that is there in that, if it is 5 or more than 5, then we will add 1 to the given place and numbers or the digits that are there on the right side of the given place are replaced by 0. Right? Step number 3 says, if the digit on the selected place is less than 5, then in that case, we will just replace the digits on the right side of the given place by 0 and the rest of the number will remain as it is. For understanding these steps, let us focus on the question that is given. Round off 32,851 to the nearest 10, 100 and 1000. So we'll write 32851. Step number 1, select the immediate place on the right side of the given place. Given place is 10, 1s, 10s. This is our given place. Selected place will be 1. Right? Step 2. If the digit on the place selected is 5 or more than 5, place selected digit is 1. It is not 5 nor more than 5. So we will not follow step number 2. Step 3. If the digit is less than 5, the digit on the selected place is less than 5, in that case, then replace the digit on the right side of the given place. Right side of the given place, digit is 1, we'll replace it by 0 and rest of the digits will remain as it is. So this is our answer. Suppose we need to round off 32851 to the nearest 100. In this case, the given place will be 1, 10, 100 is our given place. Selected place will automatically be 5. If the number, now step 2, we will be following. If the place selected, if the digit on the place selected is 5 or more than 5, then add 1 to the given place. 8 plus 1 is 9 and replace the digits on the right side of the given place by 0. This will be your answer. Now suppose we need to round off 3, 2, 8, 5, 1 to the nearest 1000. So selected place will be 8 and given place will be 2. Right? The selected place is more than 5. Therefore, we'll add 1 to the given place. 32 plus 1 is 33 and replace other digits by 0. Right? So, this will be our answer. Right? Now, after rounding off, we'll be doing approximation. Right? The question says, find the approximate difference to the nearest 100. We need to find the approximate difference. In exam, most of the time, children get confused with this and they just subtract 200 and they just subtract the numbers. And then, whatever the answer comes, whatever the difference comes, they round off this to the nearest 100. 1 stands 100. So, it will be rounding off will be 500. Right? That is wrong. First, we need to round off each integer that is given. 757 to the nearest 100 will be 757 tens 100. It is 5 or more than 5, therefore add 1 to the given place and replace other by 0. Then 216 to the nearest 100 will be, it is selected place is having 1, so it is less than 5, so we will replace other digits by 0 and the given place will remain as it is. So now after approximate, after taking out the round, after doing the rounding off, then we need to perform the difference operation. Answer will be 600. So keep this in mind. First, we need to round off the terms and then we need to perform the operation. Don't do the opposite thing. Right? Second thing, in exam, this question can be framed as find the approximate sum. Instead of difference, there can be sum. Instead of sum, there can be multiplication. They can be quotient, right? Nearest 100 can be replaced by tens, thousand and so on, right? So be alert. You know how to do it in the best possible way. Now children, we'll be dealing with international system of writing numbers or simply international system. To understand this, let us first have a quick view of international place value chart. Just like Indian place value chart or Hindu Arabic place value chart, this international place value chart is also divided into two parts, periods and places. Then what is the difference between the place value chart of Indian system and international system? The only difference is that in international system, all the periods have got three places inside them. Like once period has got once, tens, hundred. Thousand period has got thousand, 10,000 and 100,000. Millions period has got million, 10 million and 100 million. Whereas in Indian system, only the once period has got three places. Rest every period has got two places each. And the second place in Indian system is thousands only, but it has got only places up to 1,000 and 10,000. Then we have got lakhs and then crores in Indian system. To understand the difference between both the systems, that is international system, and the system that we Indians follow, that is Hindu Arabic system, let us focus on this particular question. The question says, represent 4285653395, this number, on international place value chart and Indian place value chart, and write its notation and numeration in both the system. Right? So for that, first we will start with the place value chart. As I told you before also in the first video, like when we are filling the values in the place value chart, we fill the digits starting from extreme right and we move on to extreme left. Right? So the first digit of the number is 5, which will come under 1's place. Followed by 9, that will come under 10's place. Followed by 3, that will come under 100's place. Followed by 5 again, that will come under 1000's place. Then 6, then 5, then 8, then 2, and then 4. One thing we need to keep in mind that after every period we need to put commas. After every period, right? Now we need to write our given number in notation form. Notation form, when we are writing a number in notation form, we'll just remember one thing, that after every period we'll put a comma. So we'll 4 to 8, one period is over, comma. 5, 6, 5, one period is over, comma. 3, 9, 5. So this is a notation in international system of writing numbers, right? Now we need to write its numeration. Numeration means writing in words or simply number names. That means we have to write the number name in international system of writing numbers. So number name for this will be 465,000 395. And we'll keep one thing in mind, there will be no and in between, there will be no comma in between while writing numeration, and there will be no S. Though in the place value chart we write millions, thousands, ones, but while we are writing that, while we are writing the number in numeration form, we will avoid S, we will not use S. Neither will use comma in numeration. In notation we will use comma, but in numeration we will not be using it, right? Now let us move on to Indian system. Now we need to put this number in the Indian place value chart. The same procedure, we'll start filling digits from right to left. The first one is 5, that will come under 1's place, followed by 9, then 3, then 5, then 6, then 5, then 8, 2, 4, right? Next we need to write the given number in Indian system in notation form. Notation form means writing in figures. 42,85,65,395. So after every period a comma is a must, right? In numeration form, we have to write the same number, but in Indian numeration, right? So for that, we'll be writing 42,85,65,395. We can also write and here, but nowhere else, right? 395, right? We can write like that, but if possible, don't write and anywhere, don't put comma, and don't put any S. Right? This brings us to the end of chapter number 1 of our first term. Hope you all followed the entire lecture of mine. I will be providing you all notes through Campus Care or our eCare team. Thank you and have a safe and blessed holidays ahead.